spend money on us while we get ourselves ready for the clown. So I think everybody is in place now, and I present to you, may the farce be with thee.
Thank you. boar's head carol. The boar is dead. Lo, here is his head. What man could have done more than his head off to strike, meleaguer-like, and bring it as I knew before?
Fancy, and we fancy you'll have fun.
gallant knights of the Golden Fleece. The days of the Golden Fleece? The days of our lives? Okay, I'll make it easier. How many have heard of Harry Potter or American Idol? Oh. Good, I think we've made contact. Now how many think we have spared no expense to get those people right here on our stage? Yeah? Good. Dream on, baby, but stay posted. I'll meet Patriots fans in the audience. Well, don't worry, and don't give up. We will try to keep it simple. Watch my lips. Tonight we do not have the famous Knights of the Golden Fleece, but we do have, leading the cast in size but not in wit, the unfamous, and soon to be infamous, Knights of the Golden Force. May the Force be with me. Needing no introduction and getting none is the Dragon, played tonight by Arnold the Falconer. The star of tonight's cast, so to speak, is the Comet, commonly called Halley's Comet. Stay alert, and perhaps that will be the first one at thy table to see it.
Wouldn't that be fun?
A star is born. Also appearing tonight, if he does not forget his lines, is the grand worthy master and all-knowing wise person and seer. And his trusted companion, Manuel, as well as Guinevere the Good, Charles the Squat, Orville the Magnificent, and Frederick the Less than Magnificent. We begin the action this evening with everyone in the cast looking for the comet, but we need thy help. We want to make them believe that they are actually seeing it. Please, everyone, say after me, ah.
Ah.
It's
Halley's Comet.
Wow!
You're not
being so nice to me. I hope that I have contributed in my tiny role to making your magical dinner a success. If I had made thou happy, and thus dost feel that next year I could have a much larger role, please talk to my agent or my manager. Here's my card. Call anytime.
Please, I'm calling for thee now to stop this incessant blabbing and tell us whether or not thou hast seen a comet.
No comet.
No comet?
Well, with his acting, he is not only no comet, but also no star.
Get back.
No comet. No star.
Jester, did thou think of that? Or was that planning ahead of time?
Heavens, I think this joke you are milking way too much.
Milky Way, ooh, that is clever. In fact, it is out of this world. I mean, like, spacey.
Hold, enough, I am the laugh. I mean, the Jeffer. Jester? Oh, I think I'm going down the black hole and it's right on this stage. With this heavenly body, I could be a star. But I remember what famous astronomer Sunny Moon said. Into the heavens we may go far as we navigate through the void. But here on Earth, one day a star, the next an asteroid.
Oh, my wee little heart, doth be mightily, I break through this comet, oh, what shall we do?
We must consult the seer!
Yes, the seer will be able to tell us what will happen.
I agree, the seer is quite good. But first we should consult the Bhagwan. He needs money and will work cheap.
Bhagwan! What hast thou to say?
Please, I am not Bhagwan. I am Bhagmanuel. I have very little to say because, like I said before, this is the first time that I have acted. If I had known that this was going to be a major role, I would have learned my lines. As they say in theater, line please.
If it were not for heredity and environment.
Thank you. I remember now. It's my first time, you know. If it were not for heredity and environment and talent, I could be a star, or at least an asteroid. Thank you. My card.
Maybe he will compromise and be half star and half asteroid? Oh, grand worthy master and all-knowing wise person and seer, what doth thou predict?
Say it again.
Louder.
Louder.
Oh, grand worthy master and all-knowing wise person and seer, what doth thou predict? What doth the comet pretend?
Comets, these blazing stars, threaten the world with famine, plague, and wars. To princes, death, to kingdoms, many crosses, to all estates, inevitable losses, to herdsmen, rot, to plowmen, hapless seasons, to sailors, storms, to cities, civil treasons.
Is that the good news or the bad news?
Plague and rot?
No, I think he said rot and plague.
Rot and luck, I would say.
Please, great seer, tell us how to defend against this comet.
We must take initiative. Tell us how.
We need a system to defend our space. Tell us now, great seer.
Tell us.
Yes, tell us.
Tell us how. Tell us now. Tell us. Please, dost thou not know that I am the great seer, not the teller? Thou must go to the next window for the teller. Initiative system. Thou couldst call it a Star Wars plan. No, that will not work. Aha! Thou couldst call it a Comet Wars plan.
thou must break the spell of the comet.
How dost thou foresee that this spell can be broken?
Foresee? Didst thou say foresee? Well, thou must ask the seer, not the teller. He is at window one.
How dost thou foresee the spell can be broken?
The spell of the comet can be broken only by a dragon tap dancing to the strains of Deck the Hall with Wows of Halley. The spell will then be broken for another 76 years.
A dragon tap dancing to the strains of Deck the Hall with Wows of Halley. Well, that should be easy. They say, when the going gets tough, the going gets tough, something like that. Where's Batman when you need him?
It sounds like a job for the Knights of the Golden Farce.
Call the Knights. Call the... Whoming call? Oh, wow. This I can handle. The calling of the Knights. Friday night.
Yo!
Saturday night.
Yo!
Sunday night.
Yo!
Monday night.
Not here, sire.
And why not?
Monday night football, sire.
Of course.
Tuesday night.
Yo, ho ho, sire. Dragons are forsooth our specialty, especially when their fires have already really ceased to be. 'Tis no mistake to be discreet when challenging a foe. Discretion is the best part of valor, as you know.
Whenever there is trouble, wherever there is strife, thou wilt find us on the double, sometimes running for our life. So gallantly through the kingdom as we may discreetly flee, though we knights may not be present.
May the farce be with thee!
Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Tuesday, art thou knights of the weak or knights of the strong?
Knights of the weak, sire.
No, that doesn't sound good.
No, we are not knights of weakling.
I think we've been tricked. We should tell him we're strong. It sounds better.
Correction, sire. We are not knights of the weak, as we are knights of the golden farce. We are knights of the strong, sire.
And strong thou must be, knights of the golden farce. I hereby charge thee to find a dragon, tame the dragon, and teach the dragon how to tap dance to the strains of Deck the Hall with Wows of Halley. And this, and only this, will break the curse of Halley's Comet.
Wow.
A dragon, sire? But I'm afraid of dragons.
Deck the Hall? Really, sire? But I do not think I know that song.
Of Halley's Comet, sire?
Wow!
Wow. It's getting closer!
Gracious sire! We are the knights of the week!
And we really must be going.
It has been great fun!
How kind of you to let us come.
Ta-ta! Goodbye!
Wait! If thou dost think the curse of the comet cause consternation, thou hast not heard of the curse of the royal court.
To any knight who disobeys the king, may a thousand crawling creatures infest his armor, and a thousand chickadees make nests in his helmet.
Ah, correction, sire.
We were just kidding.
hearts, and we will gladly do thy bidding.
Well thought, knights. I shall give the jesters charge over thee. Come hither, jesters. I dub thee Sir Jesters, worthy knight of the Order of the Golden Farce. May the farce be with thee. Now go get that dragon.
But I have no sword. Correction, sire. Seems like I guess I have about 4 swords. Well then, soon will be nightfall.
Don't say nightfall.
Well, we must be gone. Let's go get that dragon.
Through our teeth.
Now to break the curse of Kali's comet.
Wow!
We must get the dragon to tap dance while we all sing.
It is a well-known fact that dragons will only tap dance if everyone assembled sings.
But how will they know the words?
They are printed in their programs. A little insert in their programs.
Clever, eh?
But now, please help us rid the kingdom of the spell of Kali's Comet. Join us in song, and together we will get this little dragon to dance.
Come on.
friends. Good dreams.
And it would be at this point in the evening where there would be a mini concert at the end of the event, and so we'll sing three more songs for you, and then we'll break for our intermission, go out for the raffle baskets, and then we'll come back and do the full normal concert.
This is Christ.
So that was the North Hill Singers. They are an auditioned group that meets entirely outside of the school day. I'm hoping the next group is coming onto the horizon. They were supposed to go up these steps so that they weren't running into each other. The group that is about to come on the stage is the Choral. They are our treble choir, or upper voices, soprano and alto, mostly made up of 9th and 10th grade students. They meet every day, or days 1, 2, and 3, or days 4, 5, and 6. And the robes sometimes like to get stuck in the rail. Aren't they lovely robes, though? Thank the district for paying for those. We have several selections for you. The first one is a Hanukkah piece in three parts called Sivivan, about the dreidel spinning. And then we have I'll call it a text painting piece. It must have been a poem or some sort of literary piece that was then set to music. And so it's in an uneven meter, so not all of it's not in a traditional 4 or 3. It's whatever the words in those phrases were. And so the person who wrote it was really trying to capture the essence of the words. And then the final one is a jazzy arrangement of Jolly Old St. Nicholas. Yes. The Choral.
Thank you.
Now entering the stage is our symphonic choir. This is the mixed ensemble of soprano, alto, tenor, bass voices from 9 through 12. Uh-huh. Now we just have to see what's going to happen every single time. We have four selections for you. One is a Hebrew piece, Hanerot Hallelu, speaking about Hanukkah, that just ended this past weekend, followed by, from the movie Polar Express, Hot Chocolate, giving us a little bit of jazz, running bass line throughout the entire song. After that, we have a very beautiful lyrical piece talking about the holiday season, and then we end with it's a unique arrangement of Christmas Tree. It's from the same series that our arrangement of Silent Night comes from. So they've taken the traditional Christmas carol that's in 3 and moved it into 4, and then also added in a little bit of kind of gospel harmonies to it. It was originally written for the Young People's Chorus of New York City when they sang at the Rockefeller Center tree lighting back in like 2003. And so we hope you enjoy those four selections from Symphonic Choir.
Ding dong, 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 ding
believe we have some raffle baskets of 50-52. Let folks know about some last minute shopping, some of your gifts you may be able to take with you.
Thank you.
our North Hills tradition for going back 50 plus years. Anybody who has gone through the North Hills High School Choral program that would like to come up and join us in the singing of Hallelujah Chorus, please come up to the stage. Copies of the music are on the edge of the stage.
Thank you.
little longer concert than we're used to. I hope that you had some fun. Hope that you got into the holiday spirit, and I hope you enjoy your break. And we'll see you again in the spring.